Hello everyone, my name is Pimin Abraham and in today's video we are going to talk about electric potential at a point and due to a point charge. So this is the first video of your chapter number 2, so stay tuned for the other videos. So without wasting any more time, let's get to the topic. So at the name says electric potential at a point, we'll talk about electric potential, how we can find out electric potential at a point and electric potential due to a point charge. Due to a point charge, what will the value of electric potential, right? So basically we have to first talk about how we can define electric potential at a point, right? So according to the convention definition says it is defined as the work done by the applied force or external force in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to a point unaccelerated. Okay, let me make you guys understand this by simple diagram. So basically electric potential at a point, how we define it according to our definition, we'll go by the definition. So according to our definition says it is defined as the work done by applied force or the external force in bringing the unit positive charge from infinity to a point unaccelerated. That means let's imagine for a time being that I have a positive Q charge which is sitting over there, right? Okay, great. And I have very far away place, let me call that place infinity. It's very far away from this positive Q charge, right? And at infinity, let's say I have a unit positive test charge, let me call it Q naught charge, right? It's a unit, it's positive in nature, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to grab this unit positive charge and I'm going to bring it to a desirable point. Let me say my desirable point is somewhere here. Let me call this point B. I want my unit positive charge to be there. So what I will do, I'll grab this unit positive charge from infinity and I will drag it to this point B. Now, I will be very careful about two things, because in the definition it says that you have to bring the charge, but in such a way that the charge should not accelerate in the process, right? Now how I'm going to do that? I'm going to bring this charge so slowly that the net charge or the net force that is acting on that charge will be equal to zero. Okay, now I'm sure a lot of things are going out of your out of your head, but let me make you guys understand that. So when I'm bringing this positive charge to this place P, right, in the vicinity of this positive Q charge, now you have to understand few things. So when I'm bringing this charge, so let's say I'm bringing this charge, let's say this charge is halfway. So one thing that you have to understand is this: while I was bringing this Q naught charge from infinity to this point P, this Q naught charge is going to experience a resistance. Now resistance by who? You have to understand here, this is a positive charge, right? And because it's a positive charge, there will be electric field all around its, all around its vicinity, yes or no? So it will spread electric field in all possible direction, right? In all possible direction, electric field or electric field lines will be there, yes or no? So while this charge is coming here, so there will be an electric field line in that direction also, right? So as we have studied, it is a charge particle and it is kept inside an electric field, right? It will experience a force in the direction of the electric field, obviously. So as this charge, that is the Q naught charge, is definitely going to experience a force in that direction. I hope you guys can understand that. Now that force is because of the positive Q charge. Is that a yes or no, right? So let me call that force electric force, because it is coming from this electric charge. Is that a yes or no, right? Yes. So when I am bringing that charge to the point P, I am experiencing a resistance because of the electric force, right? So what I am going to do, I am going to apply this force, right? That is my applied force, right? I am going to apply a force to counteract that Fe. So that's how I am going to bring my charge from infinity to point P, right? I have to apply a force that will counteract my Fe, right? So let me call it applied force. So I will apply a force which will cancel the effect of Fe. But let me say, I have applied that force in such a manner that the net force that is acting on Q naught charge is actually zero, so that there should not be any acceleration, right? We are very very particular that there should be no acceleration, right? So I'm bringing it with such a slow speed that there is no acceleration. The net force that is acting on the Q naught charge is actually zero. I hope that is understandable. Is that a yes or no? Right? So if that is understandable, now you have to understand, it is defined as the work done, right? So now work done is important. Now this new term work done, we have studied it in our 11th standard, in our 9th standard also. So what was your work done? Work is always done by the force. Yes or no? That is the first point we have to understand. And the force should produce a displacement in the direction of the force. The force that is doing the work should produce a displacement in the direction of force. Then only we can say yes, work is being done, right? So in this particular case, can you guys observe this Q naught charge, and there is a force, that is the applied force is there, right? And this, because of that applied force, displacement is also there. So one thing is very sure, that this applied force actually working. This applied force is working. Is that a yes or no? I hope that is understood. The applied force is actually working, right? Great. So I can write it here. I can write it, work done by the applied force can be given as, now the formula for work done, I'm sure all of you know, the formula for work done is, let's say your work is, let's say your position, right, the charge that you brought was from infinity to the point P. So I'll put the limit from infinity to point P, right? Work done will be F, that is the applied force dot dr, the displacement vector. So this is how we defined our work done. I hope that is understandable to everyone. Is that a yes or no? Yes, great. Now here in this scenario, I can actually, my applied force is equal to my electric force. Yes or no? I hope you guys can understand that, because I was very particular that I should apply the applied force such that it should cancel out my electric force. So I can say the applied force is actually equal to your electric force. Is that a yes or no? I hope that is understandable. So if that is true, I can write work done by the applied force is actually equal to infinity to point P. I can replace this, F applied to F electric dot dr, right? Now it's a dot product, so I can actually expand this in this form, infinity to P. I can write it F dr, let's say F is actually F, I'm just assuming it, right? F dr cos of theta, where theta is the angle between your force vector, that is electric force vector, and the displacement vector. Okay, now let's go back to this diagram. So you guys can see the electric force is in this direction and displacement of the charge is in that direction. So tell me, can you guys see the angle between them is actually 180 degree? Is that a yes or no? Right? I hope you guys can understand that the angle between them is 180 degree. Great. So if that is true, I'm going to just put the value here, right? That is infinity to point P F dr cos of 180 degree, right? Now we all know what is the value of cos 180. Cos 180 is minus 1, right? Great. So I can write it here, minus of infinity to point P, this is F dr, and that is equals to work done by the applied force or the external force, whatever you want to call it, right? External force is the applied force, right? Great. So I know I got the value. Let me call this equation number 1. Now let's go back to our definition. Definition stated that what is your electric potential at a point? It is defined as the work done by the applied force in bringing the unit positive charge. Work done by the applied force on the unit positive charge. So tell me, I define my electric potential, let me say at point P, and it is represented by the symbol V. V is the symbol for your electric potential, right? So it is defined as work done by the applied force on the Q naught charge. So can I say work done per unit charge? Yes or no? Work done by the applied force on Q naught charge, that is work done per unit charge. Is that a yes or no? Right? Can I say it like that? Just take a moment to understand this, right? Take a moment to let that thought go inside. Can I write it like that? Work done by the applied force per unit charge, because work is done by the applied force on that Q naught charge. Is that a yes or no? Great. Now let's move on with that thought. So your V, the electric potential, is given as, now I know the value of work done by the applied force, which is like minus of integration from infinity to point P, wherever you want to, you know, find out, wherever you want to find out the potential, you will have to bring the charge from infinity to that point, right? FdR. Now here you have to understand very important point. Actually this electric potential, right, electric potential is actually a difference. You cannot simply say electric potential at a point. We always talk about electric potential difference, right? So instead of this, I can write electric potential at point P minus electric potential at infinity. It's a difference, it's a comparison between two different places. So like I said, you're bringing the charge from infinity to a point P. So I can write it electric potential at point P minus electric potential at infinity, that is equals to minus of this is divided by Q naught, right? So this can be written as minus of integration from infinity to point P F dr divided by Q naught charge. Now one important point you have to understand here is that electric potential at infinity is always considered to be zero. There is no potential of electric potential at infinity, right? So that is something which you have to understand. So electric potential goes to zero. That's how we get electric potential at a point P, right? And that is equals to minus of infinity to point P F dr divided by Q naught, right? And one more important thing which you have to understand, force per unit charge is what we call as our electric field. If you guys remember that, yes, right. Force per unit charge is what we call as our electric field. So we can write it Vp is equals to minus of infinity to point P Edr. And this is how you define electric potential at a point, right? Is that a yes or no? So electric potential at a point is defined as Edr from infinity to point P. See, now important thing that you have to take from here is that you cannot say electric potential. We always talk about electric potential difference, right? Potential difference is the term we talk about. Now if you want to find out potential at a point, you have to, you know, put, or you have to take a condition, you have to take a condition in such a way that the other potential goes to zero, so that you can get the potential at a single point. So how you can do it? You have to assume that one potential is at infinity and the potential is at some place where you want to find the potential. Is that a yes or no? That's right. So the same thing was being done here. I hope that is understandable. Great. Okay, now few important things. As you guys can see, it was a scalar product, or I can say it was a dot product. So important revelation is that your electric potential, that your electric force was vector quantity, right? Electric field was vector quantity, but here electric potential is actually a scalar quantity, right? So here electric potential is a scalar quantity. It is not a vector quantity, it is a scalar quantity. So it is basically a number, right? You have to understand it's basically a number, so it is not a vector quantity. You don't have to talk about directions here, right? Great. Now what will be the SI unit for V? Now V is defined as work done per unit charge. Yes or no? That is how you define your V, right? So work has a unit of joule, charge has a unit of coulomb, so joule per coulomb will be the SI unit of your electric potential. I hope that is understandable. Is that a yes or no? Yes? Great. Now very quickly let me do one more important topic. That the topic is electric potential at a point due to a point charge. Now you have to assume I have a point charge. Let's say let me call this point charge Q. Now because of this point charge I'm supposed to find out electric field at any particular point, right? Let's say at P point I'm supposed to find out electric potential because of this Q charge, right? Now how I'm going to do it? Yes, the process is same. I'm going to assume a point which is like far away, infinity, right? So from that infinity I'm going to bring a charge Q naught, right? I'll bring this charge Q naught at a point where I'm supposed to find out my electric potential because of this point Q charge. Is that a yes or no? Right. Now again conditions are same, that is I will bring the charge in such a way that it is not accelerated while I'm bringing it, right? So obviously I brought this charge Q naught here, right? And let's say this is at some distance r, right? So we all know, we just studied in the previous exercise that your potential, right, or I can say electric potential at a point, right, is simply given as the work done by applied force divided by the Q naught charge, the charge that you're the work is being done on, the charge on which the work is being done, right? So V is given as work done by the applied force on the Q naught charge, right? Great. Now V at R is actually given as, and you can also write it, you are bringing the charge from infinity to let's say some point P, and that point P has a distance R from the charge. So instead of point P I can actually write R distance, because I'm bringing it at R distance from the point Q charge, right? I hope that is understandable, right? And also I can write it EDR. Is that a yes or no? Right. Now we all know the value of electric field, right? How? Because we know from our previous chapter, if I have a Q charge, right, I'm supposed to find out electric field at some distance R, and let me call this P. Electric field is simply given as K Q upon R square. Is that a yes or no? Now this is something which we all know, right? So this value of electric field is given, E is equals to K Q upon R square. Now this is something which I know, so all I have to do is just put that value there. I'll get V at R is equals to integration from infinity to R. Now very important, there is a negative sign here which we forgot. You have to write the negative sign, don't forget it, right? Negative sign, infinity to R. Here it is K Q upon R square times of dr. Is that a yes or no? Now remember, your K and Q are constant quantity, right? So that will come out of your integration. You will left with V at R is equals to minus of K Q integration from infinity to R, this is 1 upon R square dr. Now we have to do some integration here, right? Okay, you can do it, I'm sure you can do it. So let's do it. So this will be V at R is equals to minus of K Q, right? Now integration infinity to R, I can write it R to the power minus 2 dr, right? So I can do the integration. Now we all know how the integration works, so let me just take the rough work here. So if integration, it is given x dx, the integration is x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c. If the limits are not there, if limits are there, you have to apply the limits, right? So here you guys can, if it is written r to the power minus 2 dr, that means simply r, the answer will be r minus 2 plus 1 upon minus 2 plus 1. Is that a yes or no? I hope that is understandable. So I'll apply the same thing here. V at r will be equal to minus k q, integration will be r to the power minus 2 plus 1 upon minus 2 plus 1, and the limit, that is infinity to r. Is that a yes or no? I hope that is understandable, right? Great. So V r will be equal to minus k q, and this will be r to the power minus 1 divided by minus 1, yes or no, infinity to r. I hope that is understandable, and you will get V r is equals to this is minus k q upon 1 upon r and minus sign is there, infinity to r. I hope that is understandable. So now let's apply the limits. KQ upper limit minus lower limit, that is 1 upon minus r plus 1 upon infinity. I hope that is understandable. 1 upon infinity is actually 0. Anything divided by infinity is actually 0. So we'll be left with V at r is simply given as KQ upon r. And there will be no direction because it is a scalar quantity, right? So important thing that you have to understand here is, now what does this result mean? This result mean that, for example, let's talk about electric field. So when we talked about electric field, if we had a positive Q charge, and because of that positive Q charge I'm supposed to find out electric field at some r distance, then the value was simply E is equals to KQ upon r square. Yes or no? Very similarly, now let's say I have a positive Q charge, and because of the positive Q charge I'm supposed to find out electric potential at some distance r at point P, then that is simply given as V at point r is actually equals to KQ upon r. This is the difference. If we are talking about electric field, this will be KQ upon r square. If we are talking about electric potential, that is KQ upon r. I hope that is understandable, right? Is that a yes or no? Great. So that's all for today's video. Stay tuned for next topics. So I hope you understood the, you know, video. If you have any doubt, you can comment it down in the comment section. So that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.